That is why, and as you probably can see, you see, this is when you have an operating room procedure, depending upon the procedure, you arrive in a group. And when you don't have an operating group procedure, you have a principal diagnosis, and following the different precise, you see, acute and subacute endocarditis, or cardiac arrest, or peripheral vascular disease, you have different groups. It's easy to understand. You have the documentation on paper, but it is not asked to human to do that. The human, they code the diagnosis and the procedure. You see, after, it is an algorithm. And of course, depending upon the country, and depending all the localization, and even depending upon the version in the United States, it changed a little bit. But you see, this is a kind of black box on which experts are agreeing, and then it's not, there is no human intervention for that, or not at the same level. And then you need to have, to relate that to the, at that time, with that, you have group, DRG group, okay? So, of course, you can use, if you are able to relate this DRG group to a department of an hospital, you can do benchmarking, but only, for instance, with length of stay. If you wish to have real economic information, you need to use the so-called cost model, Yale cost model, which is a method disaggregating the total hospital expenditure to arrive to be able to say this patient has consumed this part of the amount. Okay? And it's not so easy for you start, you see, at the level you have to prepare, you have to collect, and you have to receive the information, and more or less, you see, you start by the general accounts of the hospital, you must split off in overhead, ancillary services, clinical services, and some non-inpatient cost center, for any, in any hospital, it's not exactly that. You allocate, then you have final cost center, inpatient cost, and then when you have inpatient cost, you link with the DRG to have the cost by DRG. Okay, so you, and of course, this Yale cost model as well cannot be done by hand. It is necessarily a software. So that is why I don't go too much in detail for that. But you see, when you are beginning, the most important is the clinical coding on diagnosis and procedure. With that, you're able to know the DRG of your patient. Okay? But to have all the advantage of using the DRG, you need to go to more detail, to analyzing the cost. And you cannot, you see, you have to disaggregate, as they say, the general accounts, and by expelling something, and finally arriving, you see, to the cost of a patient in this clinical department, and then in this DRG. And then you have, after, what is named the cost of the DRG. And they say the cost, and you compare this cost in when we are in a country using the PPS with the price, the health insurance of the government is paying for this cost. And you compare this cost, and this has a real meaning, you see, for you know exactly the type of the patient, and you know really what the hospital has spent for this type of patient, and how he has received as the price of this. So more or less than the cost. Okay? So. Yes, please.
You know, I was just thinking because we don't have, in India it's well known that costing is a weakness. It's a weak link in management of hospitals and healthcare.
Mm-hmm.
It is more or less done on charges.
Mm-hmm.
So just the price. Even the kind of competition that...
If you have good charges, it's not too bad.
Okay, okay.
Okay. Question is, how the charges are done.
Yeah. So I'm actually going back to what you said about length of stay, because, you know, just for the discussion, is length of stay is something which is easily available,
even right now, because you have the admission date and the discharge date.
So
you can do benchmarking in length of stay by DRG.
So is that a good place to start, maybe here in Mumbai? Would you recommend that?
Of course.
So
when you start always with length of stay.
Length of stay, okay.
But and it is not a mean length of stay for a hospital or a mean length of stay for the department. It is a length of stay for a patient group.
Patient group, yeah. For the diagnosis group.
A diagnosis group.
And then...
DRG group.
DRG
group. Don't say diagnosis for... I don't think the term was not invented by me. But diagnosis-related group is a lot misleading. People it's just a clustering of diagnoses.
Yeah, no.
And there are procedures.
Definitely. Okay.
So it's more than that. It's related to the diagnostic, but it's a DRG group.
Yeah, okay. So in that sense, do you foresee any problems? Because that you've watched it, I think, this entire evolution of DRGs, when they work with the length of stay. And now it's gone to the stage where people are breaking up and de-aggregating and re-aggregating costs. So in that experience, what has been your learning? When you do LOS, what do you watch out for? What are the problems you watch out for?
I think you must not take the excuse that you don't have good cost by patient not to implement DRG, okay? So, which means that at the beginning, you use DRG as length of stay, as it's said by economists, as a proxy of cost. And in an important number of cases, it's good. It's good. It's not so bad. It's not a bad proxy. The question is, of course, for instance, when you have very intensive care, ICU, okay? Of course, the length of stay is not good. So you know in some place, and you see, for instance, in many systems, including the French one, there is a price by DRG. But when the DRG is in an ICU, we add a per diem. Okay? So, but to start, I think, to have an overview of the cost, length of stay is not at all a bad proxy. So, in fact, yes. Really, to start, the first pilot, coding diagnosis, coding procedure, dot. That's the critical point.
How frequently is the cost data collected in other countries? Is it a yearly process, once in a year, where this analysis is done and the cost per DRG is calculated? And I guess that's how the rates for each DRG, the reimbursement rates are also defined. Is it done on the yearly basis or what's the frequency of this?
I am not sure to catch your question exactly.
He's asking about the cost revision, how frequent it happens.
Ah, the cost, yes. For there is two things, you see. What I am showing is how you compute the cost in one hospital, okay? That's one thing. Then, what I was showing on the previous slide is how you compute, you infer from the cost, the price for all a country. And that is the Australian example, okay? So to fix the price, of course, you need data. And you need data on cost. So you must collect all, or in Australia it needs all. In France it's much less. You must ask hospital to send their cost data, not only their DRG data, but the cost data, okay? And it is, in several countries, an hard exercise. For it must be very detailed, you see. More or less, you must be able, for instance, to give the nursing time pass for one DRG. That means that you must know the nursing time pass by patient for all the patients of the hospital. You see? And relate how many minutes for patient so-and-so you pass, okay? So it's very difficult. In Australia, they have very high level of hospital sending that. And then after, you do the sum, you have a cost, and you have the mean cost for Australia, for instance, okay? And of course, you can decide to prefer this type of treatment than this one. So you must decide, I will increase the price compared to the cost, or I will decrease the price compared to the cost, okay? But in many countries, including France, you see, we have 1,000 hospitals, only 100 are able to send what is required by the French system, which is not very good anyway. Not detailed enough from my point of view. Less detailed than the Australian, you see. And so, but we use this sample to fix the price. And what is the frequency in Australia is every other year. Okay? For it's a very hard work to do. And so, on the other hand, you can do it less often, and you can decide for policy reason to, you see, to prefer this type of DRG than this one. So it can be, but really the full cost on a country is a hard version, but there is a good news, and that is in fact the case, for instance, in the USA, the case in Belgium, is that before entering the DRG era, most of the hospitals are paid on an individual patient bill, on charge, okay? And the charge are detailed. You have this spending for lab test, this for surgery, this for imaging and UK, is that? And the only thing to do is not to do the French mistake. We have decided to cancel all this information system to enter in the DRG era. That's not the case in the United States, for they need still to have the charge, okay, system. And for instance, in Belgium, they have kept this charge system, and they have built on that a reasonably good cost by patient system. But you see, to produce a bill with charge, you have inside the hospital all the data you need. After, when you charge, you can do different things, okay? But inside the hospital, you have a very good information system by patient, or by stay, or by patient, individual. So if you have such a system and you decide to go to the DRG, keep it.
I think hospitals here have a reasonably good charge.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not commenting on what you said about what they do with the charges.
Yeah, yeah. But what is interesting is the information system they have to produce the charge.
Charge is there.
Because you never know that how much charge means. There is obviously a markup over the cost to charge, and that's where the thing is. And how open are hospitals in sharing the data? Because what I believe, the private hospitals especially, I can talk from the Indian example, they will not be very open in sharing their cost data.
Of course.
That must be the case in the other countries also.
Yeah, yeah.
How did it happen?
It depends. You see, from what I know, I think it's the same thing in Australia and France, is that in France we have this funny, but a big legal distinction between public and private hospital concerning this point. Public hospitals are forced to give their costs by an act much before the DRG system, so it's unrelated to the DRG. But the private hospital, no. And so, to fix the price for the private hospital, the agency ask what they wish to send. And so you don't know. You don't know the relation with the reality of the cost. And I have attended a meeting in France where, and I discussed in Australia with the representative of the private clinics, and more or less, it's out of the record, they say the same. We don't give that. It is our